forecast first on Color 10 News Ozarks First.
Well, we're starting off the work week on a picture-perfect note outside right now. It's quiet. We got a little high cloudiness off to the south. Temperatures throughout the day, they've been nice. We were chilly this morning, starting off around 40, but we warmed nicely into the upper 60s. In fact, we flirted with 70, but now temperatures are starting to slide again, back through the 60s, currently 65 in Springfield, and it looks like a slow fall through the 50s this evening under starry skies, mid-40s for morning lows tomorrow, and another mild day expected tomorrow afternoon. But we will find cooler and cloudier conditions developing later this week. More on why coming up. Color 2 News at 6 starts now.
Now, from Ozarks First, you're watching Color 10 News at 6.
Predatory lending, these payday loan, these car title loan establishments are a drain on the wealth of Springfield.
A new report says Missourians are exposed to more short-term lending loans compared to other states.
That's right. The National Consumer Law Center says tonight that Missouri doesn't put a cap on annual interest rates.
Color 10's Francis Lynn joins us in our new studio to tell us a little bit more about these types of loans. Francis.
Heather, David, I spoke with local community members who are trying to educate people on short-term loans, which can have triple-digit interest rates and trap people in deep debt.
Susan Schmaltzbauer with a group called Faith Voices describes the growing problem of payday and installment loans.
The way payday loans operate, it's very confusing for consumers because it's a two-week loan. The language is purposely misleading.
Schmaltzbauer told me a bit about the efforts Faith Voices made in the past to change the way these loans are structured.
Community leaders got together around even 2010. Because they've seen the problem in their congregations, and they worked for capping the rate at 36%.
But for now, community leaders are reminding people to be extra careful when taking out a loan.
There are more payday loan companies in our state than McDonald's, Starbucks, or Walmart's combined. Some of the payday loans that I've seen firsthand, the actual paperwork, will charge up to 450%. Interest.
You know, theoretically, it could be as much as 600-700% because there isn't a cap.
Stephanie Garland with the Better Business Bureau reminds us to never pay a fee up front.
For example, some short-term loan providers are going to ask for a post-dated check to cover the amount you borrowed plus the interest and the fees. So, but if the lenders are asking for these fees in cash before giving you any money, you need to walk away.
Community members like senior pastor Daniel Chisholm at University Heights Baptist Church have been offering assistance to people who have already taken out loans.
We started looking at the teaching of Jesus about bringing good news to the poor, and we were able to accumulate some monies from within our own congregation and set it aside to underwrite some loans.
Members of Faith Voices say they're doing the only thing they can here in Springfield, drafting a city ordinance.
It requires the payday lending establishments to post across their storefronts what the true cost of the loan would be for a $100 loan.
I tried reaching out to several local loan companies in town, including Check & Go, CashNet USA, and LendNation for a comment, but my calls have not been returned yet.
All right, Francis Lynn, tonight at 6. Thanks. And happening right now, police are on the hunt for a suspect after a 45-year-old man was shot in the leg. He's recovering now from non-life-threatening injuries. Now, the police department here in Springfield says this happened in the 1200 block of East Elm shortly before 11 last night. So far, officers don't have any information to release on a potential suspect in that case at this very time.
Happening around the Ozarks, a well-known Branson performer is finally bouncing back after a year and a half off of the strip due to a theater fire.
Yeah, tonight's show, Shoji Tabuchi, will make his return to the Branson stage, though not on the stage where you would normally see him.
Our Colin Lingo is live in Branson to show us where Shoji Tabuchi is set to perform. Colin.
Yeah, David and Heather, this is the Clay Cooper Theater. It's right here off the strip. It's where big names like the Haygoods and Clay Cooper himself play every week. And tonight they're welcoming a new act. Well, a new act that Branson has already loved for years.
When trouble visited the Shoji Tabuchi Theater in May of 2017,
he hasn't been here for about a year and a half since the fire at his theater.
Branson showgoers like Jeff Benson were worried.
We were kind of wondering because it seems to be taking quite a while.
And those concerns grew as months passed without any mention of a return.
It's been close to a year and a half, and we haven't heard much news.
Finally, another Branson Theater owner has stepped up and reached out.
It's taken some time to get the restoration stuff done and the theater back up to code.
You see, before Clay Cooper and his wife Tina were theater owners, they were Branson performers themselves.
I mean, he's always been what I would consider the standard to live up to.
Before that, they were fans.
He's always been iconic to Branson.
It's why watching Shoji fall on hard times hit so close to home.
It's a lot more intricate than what people realize because there's so many things involved. You know, there's not just a couple things here or there. It's theater seats, it's costumes, it's lighting, it's sound. There's just so many different things that come into play when you have to get all of the restoration done.
And it's why they were so eager to invite him to join their theater's lineup.
We ought to call Shoji and see if, you know, we have some available spots.
And while Tabuchi is thought to return to his own stage by early 2019, the Coopers and the rest of Branson say having him gone from the Strip for even one more day would have been too long.
We definitely want Shoji here in Branson. We just think he's great for our town.
He's been here a long time, kind of an icon, and certainly glad to see he's coming back.
Now, the show that starts tonight is a Christmas show. It runs from tonight until December 21st here at the Clay Cooper Theater. Now, before you criticize it for being a Christmas show this early in the year, think of this. In Branson, for tourists, Christmas starts next week in early November. We, in fact, if you keep your eyes peeled, we saw some Christmas trees in certain storefronts just driving along the Strip. Maybe you'll see some, too, if you head down this way and take in the show. There you go. Ozarks first.
All right, Colin, our thanks to you. Want to get to some more local news now for you. Another alternative medicine store has opened in Springfield, but Hemporium in the Twin Oaks Shopping Center on South National doesn't just sell CBD oil.
Business manager Greg Lee tells Color 10 Hemporium sells all types of hemp products, including backpacks, shirts, and even paper. However, they also sell CBD products derived from hemp used for pain management and anxiety relief, which was the reason they say they wanted to put this business out there in the first place.
Store owners say they haven't had any problems opening up bank accounts or had run-ins with federal officials like other CBD shops in Springfield. However, the business is only cash or check to pay, no credit cards due to federal guidelines.
Our primary focus here is education. There's been a stigma for the last several decades against hemp and products made from the hemp plant, and we really think that it's time for an awakening.
The business will have a ribbon-cutting ceremony with the Chamber of Commerce on November 6th. Coincidentally, the same day voters will decide on allowing medicinal marijuana in Missouri. Lee says if that happens, he would consider opening a dispensary in Springfield.
Well, here's some good news now. Two Missourians are now millionaires after winning prize money in last week's Mega Millions lottery. Our partners at Missouri Net are reporting tonight that a winning ticket was sold in both Branson and also one in St. Louis. Each were worth $1 million. That's a nice payday, isn't it? However, there's still an estimated $1.6 billion jackpot out there nationwide if you play. Numbers are going to be drawn again coming up tomorrow night.
Neighbors in southeast Springfield are talking about two zoning cases at tonight's Springfield City Council meeting. One of the areas is at Battlefield Road and Lone Pine Avenue. The other is on Lone Pine, directly across from Sequoia Park. Members of the Galloway Neighborhood Association disagree with the development plan near Sequoia Park, however, are happy that council amended a bill to add more restrictions about what can be built.
Here's a live look right now at our tower camera facing historic downtown Branson. Temperatures almost reached 70 in some areas across the Ozarks, but there's a chance for some rain this week, but it's certainly feeling more fall-like. Jamie will tell you when to expect that rain, perhaps where you live. It's coming up next on Color 10 News at 6.
now, weather with Chief Meteorologist Jamie Warner.
Well, today, absolutely nice one. Beautiful evening as well with that full moon outside this evening under those starry skies. That'll make for a nice night outside if you're going to be out getting some groceries or whatnot. Conditions are quiet. Let's take a look at the temperature headlines because something kind of special happened today. We actually had above normal temperatures this afternoon. We haven't seen any of that over the last week and a half or so. 69 degrees, the high temperature in Springfield. So flirting with the 70 degree mark, that was our warmest day since October the 9th. Of course, well below a record high of 84, which was set back in 1963, but a couple of degrees above the average high of 67. And there were some 70s on the map. North of Highway 54, we managed to sneak into the low 70s. In fact, Clinton and probably Warsaw as well as Lake Ozark topping out at around 72 this afternoon. And you can see how much blue there is on the calendar. You actually have to go back to the 9th before you could find some warmer than normal readings. And of course, leading up to that was extremely warm conditions for early October. We've seen this more closer return to what it should be for the month of October with highs in the 50s and 60s, getting close to 70 this afternoon. And while I don't think we're in for warmer than normal readings for the most part for the rest of this upcoming month, it does look like we will at least have some opportunities still in there for maybe some milder days. And I think tomorrow's going to be one of them. Today, we've been ahead of a cold front. That cold front's going to sneak quietly across the area tomorrow. And it looks like in the wake of that front, we're still going to have sunshine. The cool air is actually going to lag the front and not arrive until overnight Tuesday night. So we've got another mild day on tap for the Ozarks tomorrow. Temperatures tonight chilling off to mid 40s, about 45 in Springfield, with highs ranging from the mid 60s north to upper 60s here across southern Missouri to maybe low 70s across northern Arkansas. So with sunshine and mild temperatures, a 9 on our colorator. Now looking at the longer range pattern, we're going to be giving up this sunshine. We're going to be giving up these warmer readings for a cloudier and maybe even wetter pattern later this week, at least on Thursday when a storm system moves out of the west and crosses our area. That storm will zip on off to the east, but with a nice trough developing across the eastern U.S. and getting established, we're likely going to find a storm train kind of moving right across the Ozarks. So we'll see a series of upper level storms. And while that's not going to keep us overall very wet, it will certainly present us with the chance for cloudier conditions and at times some showers as well. So here's our 7-day forecast. Sunshine on Tuesday, sunshine on Wednesday, cooler, high of 61, mostly cloudy Thursday with a chance for showers, high of 53. I think partly cloudy on Friday. There will be a chance for showers late Friday night into Saturday morning, a break, and then a chance for a few isolated showers Sunday afternoon. So looking at the upcoming weekend, maybe not as bright as this past weekend, but still not too bad.
So it's a fall-like forecast. And as we have moved now back into our main studio and giving you a glimpse of our new studio, we did not leave the Viewers Club in the old studio. It came here with us too, and you've got it to share, right?
And the jackpot continues to climb. It's at $1,300. Tonight's number is 203402.
All right, Jamie, thank you. Still ahead here at 6 o'clock, a local group says it's fighting for coverage of pre-existing conditions in Missouri. Coming up here, what Protect Our Care had to say in Springfield today.
In our political coverage this Monday at 6, pro-Democratic group Protect Our Care made a stop at an National Avenue church here in Springfield today to fight for health care coverage in Missouri. The group says it's, quote, sounding the alarm about Republican ongoing efforts to repeal Protect for people with conditions that are pre-existing. The group cited a lawsuit filed by Attorney General Josh Hawley. Local Representative Crystal Quaid and others spoke at that event about the dangers they say of allowing insurance companies to discriminate against people based on their medical histories.
Around the Ozarks, you have to take a look at this apology from a child who accidentally called 911 in Lawrence County. The sheriff posted this handwritten letter on Facebook. It reads, "I am so sorry for calling 911. I did not know my old phone really worked. Thank you so much for all you do to keep us safe." Deputies actually responded to the call, but parents used this accident as a learning opportunity.
Very cool. Coming up in sports on Color 10 News, the Chiefs were hunting Bengals last night. We've got more next.
Now sports with Dan Lucy.
The Missouri State Bears will try to bounce back into the win column Saturday when Southern Illinois comes to Plaster Stadium. In our Bear Nation report, it may be just what Steck has ordered to get his football team back on track. The Salukis will limp into Plaster Stadium on a 6-game losing streak. Missouri State's Dave Stecker will spend this week trying to fix what went wrong against Western Illinois. The Leathernecks dominated the Bears, especially in the second half, and won on homecoming 31-14. Steck says that there's still plenty of football left in this season.
This isn't Chicken Little. The sky's not falling. I mean, if you look at things, you guys look at all the wrong stats, in my opinion. There's only two teams in this whole conference, which is a great conference, only two teams with a better record than us. And we beat one of them. So with that said, we have to focus, prepare, and do like we do with the wins, is put this behind us. 24 hours is up. Now we're on to Southern Illinois.
The Kansas City Chiefs beat the Bengals last night 45-10, the victory moving Kansas City to 6-1 on the season and added more lore to the legend of Patrick Mahomes. Mahomes throwing four touchdowns and passed Kurt Warner's record for TD passes through eight games. Mahomes has 22 through seven games. Warner has 21. Next on the list is Chiefs icon and NFL Hall of Famer Len Dawson's single season record of 30 touchdown passes in 1964. Mahomes says it helps to have a weapon like Kareem Hunt.
He just takes this offense to the next level. Him being able to run the ball hard, him being able to catch the ball out of the backfield, I feel like it doesn't really get accounted for. And so I can throw a check down to him and he can break three tackles and get in the end zone. I mean, he truly is a special player who I believe doesn't get as much hype as I think he should. It should have been a tackle for loss, and then he like broke a tackle and then jumped over a dude. And I mean, that was a very talented defense who had a lot of guys that are built to stop the run, and it just speaks to the strength and the power that he has when he's running with the football.
You think he had a bad weekend? Don't talk to Mizzou basketball coach Konzo Martin. Sunday, he lost one of his talented Tigers for the rest of this season. Jontay Porter tore the ACL and MCL in his right knee, and he's out for the rest of the year. The injury happened when Mizzou was in a closed scrimmage with Southern Illinois. Porter was a five-star recruit, the brother of Michael Porter Jr., who's now with the Nuggets. Jontay was named preseason second-team All-SEC, and he skipped his senior year in high school just to join his brother at Mizzou last season. Well, now for a timeout, let's talk about the NBA. For the next couple of weeks, the NBA is the only basketball game in town. The college game doesn't tip off until the first full week of November. So the NBA has an opportunity to win over viewers like myself. So what happens? A fistfight Saturday night between the Lakers' Brandon Ingram and Rajon Rondo and the Rockets' Chris Paul. Rondo spit in the face of Paul, and then that started the fisticuffs. All three players involved getting multiple game suspensions without pay. In my opinion, this incident shows what the NBA is all about. The players run the show and set the agenda. It's the first week of the season. How can there be bad blood this early in the year? Another reason why I like to watch the college game more than the association. Well, what do you think? Does Saturday's brawl ruin the NBA's reputation? Email dlucy@culleton.com or join the discussion on Facebook, and we'll share some of your responses tonight at 10. That is sports. The news. We'll be right back.
Coming up tonight on Cullerton News at 10.
I said, someone did this to my house. Someone did this to me on purpose.
A woman who lives in the Roundtree neighborhood in Springfield wants to know who set her house on fire and why. She will share her story tonight only right here on Cullerton News. Thanks again for joining us again from our renovated studio back here on the new set tonight.
We are happy that you are here, and we hope to see you again right back here tonight at 10 o'clock.
Good night for now.